This video is about introduction to Laplace transform. So I will teach you how basically Laplace transform works. Okay, we'll give you the basic formulae and just an orientation lecture about Laplace transform. Okay, so let us begin. First, before we go to the Laplace transform, let us understand the meaning of word transform. That TR stands for a transform. Now a transform always converts a time domain into frequency domain. And this is true for all transforms. They basically convert time into frequency. And right now we are talking specifically about Laplace transform. So when I say Laplace transform, let's say the time domain function is f of t. And when you take a Laplace transform, it becomes f of s. Okay. So f of s is a Laplace transform of f of t. Now that's basically how it looks like. And one more point that I want you to note, that when you say f of t in time domain, this means the t over here is time. T stands for time. And with the same logic, if frequency domain has s, then s has to be frequency. Okay. Now with that, I will give you a formula of Laplace transform. So by Laplace transform formula, it says that f of s, that is Laplace transform of f of t, is equal to, now the formula of Laplace transform is nothing but a simple integral. That integration will go from 0 to infinity. Then you have something e raised to minus st dt. So this is the main formula. And now that you want to find out Laplace transform of f of t, you should write down f of t over here. So I'll write f of t here. Right, whichever function you have, you will write down here. And this is basically how you find a Laplace transform of any function. Now, for solving some problems on Laplace transform, what we do is we have some functions are a standard functions. And we can just like, you know, remember their Laplace transform, because very often you will find those functions. So I'm just going to quickly make a list of some functions here. And these are the standard formula you have to remember. So if you have f of t, okay, and when you take a Laplace transform, this becomes f of s. So I'm just going to write down a list of all the functions. So let's do that quickly. That let's say I have a function f of t as e raised to minus at. Now that's the value of f of t. And supposing if I take a Laplace transform, the answer will be 1 upon s plus a. Okay, now how do you get to this answer? You have to simply use this formula and solve. I will be solving this question, so you will realize how it is done. So we'll be solving some of them, but then more or less you have to remember this as a standard formula. Also, now if you have e raised to minus at, the answer is 1 upon s plus a. So e raised to plus at, the Laplace transform will be 1 upon s minus a. Okay, I hope that's quite obvious. The first one. Let me now like make a quick list of all the Laplace transform, the standard formula you have to remember. So next is if you have sine at, okay, the Laplace transform works out to be a upon s square plus a square. Okay, if you have sine phi t, it will be 5 upon s square plus 25. Okay, now if you have cos at, the Laplace transform is very similar to sine, but you have numerator, you have s. So it is s upon s square plus a square. That is the Laplace transform of cos at. So if you have cos 3t, let's say, then the Laplace transform will be s upon s square plus 9. Okay, that's quite obvious. So now these two are also standard ones you have to remember. Now the next set of functions is if you have 1, the Laplace transform is 1 divided by s. Okay, if you have a t, the Laplace transform is 1 upon s square. Okay, if you have f of t as a t raised to n, then the Laplace transform will be gamma n plus 1 divided by s raised to n plus 1. As I already told you, these are the standard Laplace transforms. So you can remember them, okay? So that you can solve advanced questions using these formulae. And now let us begin, and I will prove to you that if you have function f of t as e raised to minus at, the Laplace transform is 1 upon s plus a. We will solve like one or two problems so that you understand how exactly I've got these answers. So let us begin with those questions now. So now let's see how we can find the Laplace transform of this function. We know the answer is going to be 1 upon s plus a, as I just told you. But then we will now completely solve this question till we get the answer. Now solution begins with the Laplace transform formula. Okay, the main formula that I gave you. that if you want f of s, which is nothing but L or a Laplace transform of f of t, okay, the formula is integration 0 to infinity f of t, we write down this function here, e raised to minus st dt, okay. Now in our case, if you see, the value of f of t is e raised to minus at. So I can just simply replace f of t as e raised to minus at, okay. So this integration becomes going from 0 to infinity, e raised to minus at, e raised to minus st dt. Okay. Now all we have to do is we have to evaluate this integral. But before we do that, can we club these two terms? They both have got base as e, right? So I can easily club them. So it is going to be integration 0 to infinity. This will be e raised to. Both of them have negative sign, so I'll keep minus outside. And both of them have t as well, so I'll take t out. So I have got a plus s. I hope you followed this dt. Now all we have to do is evaluate this integral. Now for your reference, let me write down that, do you know that supposing we want to find out integration of e raised to ax dx, so you have a as a constant, the answer of this integration is e raised to ax, and then we write down the that constant over here, so it's e raised to ax upon a. So if you see in our case, you have you are integrating with respect to t, right? We are integrating with respect to t, so t is our variable and this part is going to be constant. Okay, so if I integrate this, this will come in the denominator with a minus sign. So let me write down the step, see if you understand. The answer of integration will be e raised to minus of a plus s times t divided by minus of a plus s. Okay, so that's the integral, and the limits are going to be from t is equal to 0 to infinity. So let us solve this further. So finally, f of s, I've got this as an answer. Now we will first put upper limit, which is infinity, and then we'll put lower limit, which is 0. So, well, this is minus of 1 upon a plus s. The denominator part is anyways constant. It does not have t. So this will be out. And let us put the value of t infinity, the upper limit first. So if I put t is infinity, this will become e raised to minus infinity. And when we put t is equal to 0 for the lower limit, this is the upper limit. And for lower limit, when you put t equal to 0, this will become e raised to 0. Okay. So I got this as minus of a plus s, or I can write it as s plus a. Now, do you know the value of e raised to minus infinity? Okay. I'll write down somewhere here. Say if you have, okay, let me write here. E raised to 0 is 1, because anything raised to 0 is 1. When you have e raised to infinity, anything power infinity is going to be infinity, right? Is that correct? So now if I want to find e raised to minus infinity over here, that is going to be 1 upon e raised to infinity, which is 1 upon infinity, because this value is infinity. And do you know 1 upon infinity is 0? So e raised to minus infinity will simply become 0. So let me write that. This is upper limit. This part becomes 0. Okay. And e raised to 0 will be 1. So this is 0 minus 1. And then when you have 0 minus, this is minus 1. And minus 1 time minus 1 will become plus 1 upon s plus a. And that is the value of f of s. So we have found the Laplace transform. Okay. And the answer is 1 upon s plus a. And from all this discussion, I hope you all agree that if you have to find out Laplace transform of e raised to minus at, okay, the answer is going to be 1 upon s plus a. And as I already told you, you are supposed to remember this as a standard formula. Okay, so that's the basic idea of a Laplace transform. But we will do one more question. I'll take one more standard function f of t and try to find out Laplace transform of that function. So the second question we will see is, now this time I will take f of t as sine at. And we will see what we find Laplace transform. So everything is same. We have to find Laplace transform, but right now f of t is sine at. Okay. The solving procedure has to be same. We will first begin with Laplace transform formula, which is f of s is equal to Laplace transform of f of t. And then you write integration 0 to infinity f of t e raised to minus st dt. This is the standard formula. But now this time your value of f of t is going to be sine at, right? So let me write down this as sine at. Okay, now let me write this integration nicely. The integration is e raised to minus st, this term, and this is sine at dt. Okay, now to solve this type of integral, there is a standard integration formula. Okay, I don't know if you remember that, but let me like just give you a reminder of that formula, that if you want integration of e raised to ax sine bx dx, the answer is e raised to ax divided by a square plus b square. A is here and b is here. Then this is a sine bx minus b cos bx. Okay, so we'll use this formula here, and now let us continue solving. If you compare with that formula, do you understand this value? Now e raised to ax, we have e raised to minus st. So the variable is t, and the value of a is minus s, and the sine bx, we have sine at. So this value is b. I hope you followed this. I'm basically comparing it with the standard formula, so I can write down answer like this. So now let us write down the answer. It will be integration 0 to infinity. Sorry, we will be evaluating the integral now. So the answer of this integration as per this formula will be e raised to minus st, okay, divided by what is a? A is minus s, right? So it is minus s square plus a square. The value of b is a. So b square will become a square. Then next will be, this is a is minus s. So it is minus s sine at minus, the value of b is a cos at. I hope this is correct. So we got this answer. That's the answer for integration, but we have to apply limits now. The limits will go from t is equal to 0 to infinity. Okay, so answer of f of s is going to be, well, first we'll put the upper limit. So what happens if I put upper limit here, which is t is equal to infinity? Now this will become e raised to minus infinity, and e raised to minus infinity is 0. So if this term becomes 0, the entire this term will become 0, right? So you have 0 for upper limit. I hope you followed this. When this becomes 0, entire thing will become 0. Okay, minus for lower limit, we'll put t equal to 0. If I put t 0, e raised to 0 becomes 1 divided by, this will be s square plus a square. Okay, now this is for the lower limit. Okay, 1 divided by s square plus a square. And then we will put t is equal to 0 here as well. So this will become sine 0. Oh, well, sine 0 is 0. This term is 0. So this entire thing will become 0. So the first term is 0 for this one here. Then next you will have minus a. When you put t 0, cos 0 is 1. So this is minus a. Okay, and that's the value for the lower limit. L stands for the lower limit. So what do I get finally f of s as? The value of f of s is going to be, this is minus a times minus this. So it will become minus a. This is 0 minus a is minus a, times minus is plus a, right? So it is plus a divided by s square plus a square. Now that's the final answer of a Laplace transform. Okay, we already know this answer, and we're going to anyways treat this as a standard formula. So let me once again write down the formula, that Laplace transform of sine at is equal to a upon s square plus a square. Okay, now this is the standard formula. So now we will move on to the next type of problems.